rolling along in a steamboat up in round the bend.
A sinner like you. I was a hog. I was a slave of the demon realm, a child of hell. Yes, sir. But I was saved by this ribbon. It raised me from a hog to a man. It can do the same for you. Raise your right hand and take the pledge. Brother, what do I see in your hand? Don't be a hog. Cast the enemy away. Bury demon rum in the waters of the mighty Mississippi. Fling it away, I say. I swear that henceforth, liquor shall never touch my lips.
Me too.
Bless you, brother. Bless you.
Look at that. You see that? See that picture on there? Yeah, that's Pocahontas, the wonderful little Indian woman. You know, you all know the story of Pocahontas, you know, that saved John Smith's life, you know? Well, John Smith wanted to get this remedy from Pocahontas. You know, it's, of course, it's just made out of pure roots and herbs that she picked up on the hillside. But she wouldn't give him this remedy. He couldn't get it. He had to marry her to get it. Oh, yes, he did. He had to marry her to get the remedy. And that's how it got into the Smith family. And that's been handed down from generation to generation, from Smith to Smith, right on down. And that's how it come clear down to me. My great-grandmother was a Smith.
Mine too, Doc.
I doubt it. Say, looky here. Looky here, my friends. You don't look good. Now, you're ill. You're sick, and you don't know it.
Well, I do feel kind of bad, Doc.
I knew it. I could just look at you. Would you mind stepping up here? Just get up here on the platform, will you? Now, you folks know that this man is no confederate of mine. I never saw him before. Now, along in the spring, just about the time you should go to plowing, why, you feel kind of tired, don't you?
You're right, Doc.
And you know that I'm right, don't you? You know what that is? That's spring sickness. That's what it is. It's spring sickness. And the only thing that'll cure that is Pocahontas. Pocahontas. You know, the main thing about Pocahontas is that you can't do a tap of work. You're not allowed to turn a hand until the whole bottle is empty.
You mean I can't even sharpen the axe for the old woman to cut wood?
You can't even hitch up the mules for
her. I'll take a bottle, Doc.
It's 50 cents a bottle. I haven't got change for that dollar here. You don't mind just taking another bottle, do you? You know, because, you know, you're going to be tired during the summer, and that'll carry you over till I get back. Now, who else?
I take off a bottle. Hey,
you don't have to work. Hey, I've got a few. Complete relaxation while you're taking it. Here you are. Who'll have another bottle here?
Yeah.
Hey, Doc, let me have one in 2 minutes. Oh, I'm awful sorry, lady. I haven't got any more of the 10 cents. They're all 25 cents, man. I didn't have enough.
Half a dollar, Doc.
There you are. Who'll have now? The only last. Morning, Captain Eli.
Hello, Doc. Make yourself at home.
Say, what in thunder are you doing? I'm just teaching you how to salute my boat. Clam O'Queen. You got a lane over there.
Yeah. Give her two more toots.
Hey, that's four. That's a double salute.
No. Just honoring the unburied dead, that's all.
Yeah, don't try to poke any fun at that. Duke and I just bought it. We saved up every nickel we got to get that boat.
Duke, that's your nephew, ain't it?
You bet your life. And he's a great boy, Duke.
I thought he was piloting on the Memphis Girl.
Well, he was. He's the main pilot on there, but not no more. He's making his last trip, and he's coming right on there with me.
You stick to doctrine. You ain't no steamboat man. Cramp him, Mink, cramp him.
I'll take him, Mink.
Well, admitting Duke's a pretty good boy. What could you do on a steamboat?
Well, I'm just going to sit up in the pilot's house and toot the whistle and listen to that old river sing.
Well, you brag. I suppose you fixing to stick that old apple crate yonder in the big race to Baton Rouge this summer.
I never had thought of that, but that's the idea at that. You know, the Clam O'Queen won that race in 84. And with Duke as a pilot, I'll bet you could win it again.
I suppose you'd like to bet your boat against my boat on the result of that race, huh?
Mm-hmm. I'll bet you that. I'll bet you.
You made yourself a bet and lost yourself a steamboat.
Gonna stay ashore here with us, brother? The devil's pretty active around these parts.
Hey, brother. Lords are calling me up the river. Gotta wrestle with the captain of the Memphis Girl. He's backslid.
Well, darn my britches. The Memphis Girl, huh? Say, I got a nephew works on that boat. You need anybody to help you wrestle with the devil, he'll help you. He's the best wrestler in this whole country. His name's Duke. Duke's his name. Yes, sir. He's piloting the boat.
Thank you, brother. I'll fetch him the word.
You tell him to hurry on down here. I ain't any man to be kept waiting.
Goodbye, brother. Keep the faith.
Hey, you can count on me, Moses. I ain't got no more use for liquor. Hey, stop!
Two bottles you got. Cost you a dollar.
I ain't got any money, Doc, but I can work it out.
Work it out? What can you do?
Steamboat engineer.
Yeah? Steamboat engineer? Are you an engineer? Huh? Well, say, boy, you just drunk yourself into a job. Come on in here. Well, engineer, what do you think of it?
Kind of looks like a lot of rats have to find themselves a new hole.
Well, of course, it don't look so good right now. But you got to remember that a steamboat is a female, you know? And when they're strutting up and down the river where everybody's looking at them, they're just like a woman with a new Easter bonnet on. But when nobody ain't looking at them, why, they get kind of careless and don't care.
Yeah, sloppy.
Sloppy, that's right. But with a good live man on this boat like you are, say, you can make this thing perk up, strut, get some paint on her nose, get these chickens out of here. We can put them right in the pot now. Here, start flirting with that.
Hey, but Doc, you told me yourself that a man couldn't do a lick of work when he's on Pocahontas.
Oh, that's the first bottle. But after that, you've got to work to get the best results out of it. Now, hurry up. Now, Duke's going to be here any day now, and he'll be here. Ooh, look at that. The captain. Okay. Now listen, we'll find a sign painter up the river somewhere, and we'll have chief engineer put on there, see? And if I have any room, you know, and you work good, yeah. But first, mate. Come on, now, let's get you. That you, Duke?
Hello, Uncle John.
Hey, you're kind of late, ain't you?
I guess I am, Uncle John.
Who's it for?
This is Fleety Bell, Uncle John.
She's a swamp gal, ain't she?
Oh, I guess that's right. There's some mighty fine people in the swamps.
You're acting awful queer, Duke. You done something bad, ain't you?
Mighty bad, Uncle John.
What'd you do?
I killed a man.
What? Was on account of her you done it?
Yes, sir. Can Fleety Bell sit down and get dry, Uncle John?
So, half the clan on Queen George, isn't it?
It's all right, Fleety Bell.
You only heard enough deeds, have you?
I'd mighty like something for Fleety Bell. She's about worn out.
I got some hot coffee here. I'll get some bacon in a minute. Where'd you meet her?
Well, there ain't much to tell. Was down Blue Bottle Bayou, back of Hannon, getting out timber. Some swamp people come along in their shanty boats. I used to wave at them, trying to be friends with them. But they'd never wave back or nothing. Just make the women folk get indoors. First time I seen Fleety Bell, I thought she was a boy, the way she was dressed. Well, I blowed my whistle, and she waved back. And her old man came out and gave her a whipping. After that, I seen her pretty near every day. Then her folks found out, and her old man gave her a worse whipping. And that's why she ran away.
Was it one of her kinfolks you killed?
No, sir, it was Big Steve.
Who's he?
Engineer on the Memphis Girl. When he found Fleety Bell on the steamboat where I was hiding, he started after her. You know I don't get mad easy, but when I do, it's like a thorn tree, a growing and growing inside of me. And well, we started in fighting, and he drawed a knife, and I picked up a chunk of stove wood and throwed it in his hand, and he ducked right into it. And I know by the way he fell, he was dead.
Well, there ain't nobody can say that that wasn't self-defense. Did anybody see it?
Nobody but a preacher fella. Calls himself the new Moses.
I know him. I know him. He come up on the Pride of Paducah with me. I sent a message to you by him. Did he give it to you?
Yeah, he told me.
He seen it, huh?
He seen it, and it was night, and he was sleeping on deck, and he didn't blame me none. just done a lot of praying and told me to give myself up. I don't know nothing about religion, but he's right. He's right. You gotta give yourself up. They ain't no jury could blame you for doing a thing like that. Now, come on, and sit down there. Come sit down and get you something to eat here now. Then we'll go on over and we'll see the sheriff and give yourself up.
No! He ain't gonna give himself up.
Listen here. Who asked for any opinion of yours on this thing? You've done enough to him already. Now, sit down there and get you something to eat now. He's going to do as I say. He knows that he can trust me.
No, he ain't going to do as you say. We heard tell of this hanging, Judge. Ain't nobody going to hurt Duke.
Sit down.
Sit down, Pretty Belle. Eat something. Uncle John's right. There ain't nothing to run away from.
I told you not to come here. We'd be safe in the swamp.
Oh, swamps. He's a river man. He couldn't live in the swamps. He's not that kind of people.
But they'll hang you, Duke. I know they will.
Oh, they won't do any such a thing. They won't hang him. Don't pay any attention to her, Duke. She'll only get you in worse.
You shut up and stop saying that. You're just thinking of yourself. You don't care what happens to Duke.
Now, honey. Uncle John.
I ain't never had nothing to love in my life. And I'm not going to let him take you.
Nobody's going to take me away from you, honey. Except maybe for a little while. You and me got to be free to get married and live on this boat.
If you don't come with me now, you'll never see me again.
Come on, son. Let's get on over and see the sheriff.
You let him alone!
Come on, son.
I know why you're doing this. It's because you hate me and you think I ain't good enough for him.
Coming, Duke?
I'm coming, Uncle John. But you've got to take care of Pretty Belle while I'm gone. Rube! Rube!
Sure is quiet up here.
Rube!
Yeah, hello down there. Well, good heaven, Betsy. What are you doing down there this time of night, Doc? Didn't you let a man sleep?
Oh, come on down. Duke killed a man.
Well, doggone me. Who was it, Duke? Somebody I know?
Fella named Big Steve.
Never heard of him.
Come on down, Rube.
Now, Doc, ain't no need of me coming down them stairs. Wait just a minute, I'll fix you up. Here you be, Duke. I just open her up and make yourself at home. Take the first bed to take a liking to. And, Doc, just hang the keys on the front door knob, will you? I'll be seeing you in the morning now, about breakfast time. Good night.
All right. I think somebody killed a man every day around here and come and give us that up. Sit down.
I ain't going to. You sit down. I don't want nobody waiting on me. I know you hate me, and I don't care. Duke told me to stay here, and I'm going to do it. As soon as he gets out, him and me's going away. And we ain't coming back, neither.
Maybe you're going away, but he ain't.
Yes, he is.
Now, we'll see about that. I never knew of any good coming of a river man getting mixed up with a swamp trash. Hey, look out there. Hey.
You know, say, you're a spunky little rascal, you know it? You kind of got to admire you at that.
There she is. Just wait till I get you home.
No, I ain't a-going.
I'll beat the hide off of you for this. Running off with a riverman, shaming me in the face of the Lord, making trash out of herself. I don't know if I want to marry her now.
She'll marry you, Ben, if the pop gives her a good whopping.
Oh, I won't.
You shut up. Oh, darn you, I'll beat the Lord on there.
Go ahead and beat me. That's all I ever known. Take me back. But I won't marry him, and you can't make me. I'll run away, and I'll keep on doing it till you kill me.
Now, you listen to me, and you don't have to go anywhere.
Oh, shut up. He's just looking for trouble. Go ahead, give it to him.
Ain't no sin running off with a man you love, and ain't nobody gonna make me say it is.
Now, you heard what you said. Now, go on, get out of here. Go on.
I'll bust him one.
Go ahead, Ben. Don't take none of his sass.
Ain't no river man gonna tell me what to do. She's my young'un, and I got the right.
There ain't nobody gonna tell her what to do but Duke.
I'm her Paul.
Yes, and Duke is her husband.
Her and Duke was married.
There can't be nothing wrong about that, can there?
He's lying, Pat.
I ain't gonna marry her now, no how. I don't want no riverman's trash.
You bet your life you're not gonna... Say, just a minute here. Say, I'm stood just about all the insults I'm gonna stand out of you people. You can't come in here talking to that girl like that. That's Duke's wife. Now get out of here, you swamp rat. Come on, you swamp rat. Get out of here.
Look,
get out
of here. There's my shoes.
Hey, drop them shoes.
Ow!
Fine lot of kin folks you got.
I'd mighty like to thank you for what you've done.
Well, you ought to thank. And been to me that it got you shoes.
But I mean, you fixed
well,
it.
Well, yes. If you hadn't given me the knife, you might have got them anyhow. Coming in here bothering us just when we're going to enjoy our supper here together. That's fine, a lot of kin folks having like that. Swamp people. Look at that bacon. Look at that. It's all burned. Look at that.
Let me.
No eggs in them swamp people. Look at that, huh? What do you know about cooking bacon? Never cooked nothing but catfish.
Hey, what is that? Here. What is that? Is that an old tablecloth? Somebody's, huh? What a...
You can't wear a thing like that to the cook. You can't wear that to the courtroom. You got to... I wonder Duke couldn't tell whether he's a boy or a girl. Look at that. Sure used to make them Yanks run in that.
Mother. She's the prettiest woman I ever saw in my life. Even if she was my sister.
She's skinny, like you. There you go. Letting the bacon burn up that way. That's all you women think about, just clothes.
Dr. John, you think anybody will take me for a swamp girl?
Swamp girl? What, in those clothes? No more swamp girl. Say, there's gals up in a big city like Vicksburg, that ain't got duds like those. You know where those clothes come from? Way up to Memphis.
Do you think Duke will like it?
Like it? Say, he ain't even gonna recognize you at first. Duke's gonna have two sweethearts now.
Two?
Yeah, gonna have two. You and the Claremore Queen. Say, we gotta hurry up here. Let's get to prancing here. Come on.
Me done this to Duke. It's all my fault. I ought to let him run away like you said. You was right about that hanging judge. Guess I thought because I was older that I knew more about right and wrong, and you all did.
Duke ain't blaming you, Dr. John.
I know he ain't. But you are.
I ain't blaming nobody.
You ain't no more surprised about it than I be, Doc.
You up there supposed to be saving a man's life, and then you're talking to the judge about real estate. What you want to start an argument with him for?
Well, 'twas my fault. You seen the way he led around to it. He's held a grudge against me ever since I sold him that bottom land. 'Twas my fault the river run over it.
Well, if you let me have my way and let me go find the new Moses, who's the only man that saw the thing, had him here as a witness, Duke could have been free and out of here.
Oh, shucks. He ain't been hung yet. Now, you just wait and see the way I handle this appeal.
Wait a minute. Now, you ain't gonna handle any appeal. You know what I want you to do? I want you to go down to Baton Rouge, and I want you to get a good lawyer. Get the best lawyer you can get. Get a smart lawyer.
Cost a heap of money. Them big fellas wouldn't even worry about Duke for less than $500.
Well, if his life ain't worth $500, it ain't worth nothing. Now, you go get the lawyer, will you? You get the lawyer, and I'll get the $500 somehow or another. Come on, honey.
Howdy, Doc.
Oh, hello, Rube.
Mighty sorry to hear about the way Duke's case turned out.
Well, ain't hung him yet.
That's the truth as I see it.
Ain't going to either. What's that you got there?
Well, ain't you hearing? Well, Professor Marvel done skipped town on everybody. Left his whole show and the Calliope and everything. Come on in, see the show, honey. It'll just cheer you right up. We got a dead fish in here that calls a whale. Well, the whole tent gets up full of things that'll give you the shivers. Come on in. Yes, sir. All the greatest folks in history, from John the Baptist plumb down to the King of England. There's little Eva sitting there. Old Uncle Tom's laying around here somewhere.
You know the story of little Eva, honey?
No.
This is well. Over here, look here. It's Daniel Boone.
That's Daniel Boone.
You know the story of Daniel Boone?
No.
I'll tell you that sometime. That's a great story. Oh, here, look here. I bet that's the old bloodhound, ain't you? Huh?
Got you there, Doc.
Look here, you see that statue there? That's Ulysses S. Grant.
Yeah, who's that?
Oh, the woman leading the horse?
Yeah.
Why, that's Victory.
Ain't it just like some darn Yankee to let the lady walk?
They do it every time. But look here, Doc. I bet you this here is something that you ain't never seen before. You know, there's been a heap of argument around town about this here whale. And Professor Marvel, now he claims that it's a very identical whale that swallowed Jonah.
Well, it looks old enough to be.
Yes, and look here at the size of this here mouth.
Ain't nobody in here.
Thunderation.
Ain't nobody in there, white folks.
Holy Moses.
Moses, nothing. Say, that's Jonah.
I'll wait for the doctor, and I just...
Well, come on out of there. Now, there ain't nobody going to harm you. What you doing in there?
Nothing. I just thought you thought I was Mr. Professor.
Hey, wait a minute here, Ruth. You know, I got an idea. See what you think of this, Fleety. What do you say? You want to get your money out of this, don't you?
Sure do.
What do you say? You let me take this on the Claremore Queen, and I'll soon have your money back. And we can get Duke that appeal lawyer, too.
Well, I don't see how nobody can kick about that.
Do you go with this?
Yes, I work. See, I play the banjo and mouth organ and the calio.
Calio?
Yes, I'm all right.
What's your name?
Well, I was baptized David Begat Solomon.
David Begat what?
David Begat Solomon, but I changed it to George Lincoln Washington.
Well, now listen, if you're going with me, we're going to stick right to the Bible. You're Jonah.
Yes, but I can't sue him.
What do you want this virgin queen?
Put her there by her husband. What do I know about a king and queen, anyhow? All I have to do is sell medicine up and down this river here. But I'll tell you, if we get right down to earth, you know, and we can change these people around, you know, and the people that these folks on the river want to see, we can make a lot of money. Now, for instance, who's your favorite female?
A Pocahontas.
Pocahontas, that's great. Well, now we'll just make Pocahontas out of her, see? Get some feathers and some paint and all. Who was the fellow she was with? What's his name?
Captain John Smith.
Captain John, here's Captain John Smith right here. Over here, we take this fella. Gentleman here is King George, 1, 2, 3. King George III, I never heard of him. That, we'll make that gentleman into George Washington. That's who it is. And this one over here, we'll take him. Hey, that's Napoleon. Better leave him alone. Now here's these two new Moseses here. I think they're old prophets of some kind, but they ain't nobody interested in prophets nowadays. I tell you, we'll make outlaws out of them.
Frank and Jesse James.
That's great. That's fun. Everybody wants to see the James boys.
But Justin, I done told you, Topsy goes back there with Uncle Tom. No good in where she don't goes with Napoleon. Crazy that festival was about. Hey, Mr. Ulysses S. Grant. Mr. Dr. Smith.
Grant? Say, I just happened to think. Say, we got to go right by Vicksburg.
And they ain't no forgot down there.
Wonder old Professor Marvel skipped town.
You know, I knew a fellow that got run out of Vicksburg for just looking like him.
I tell you, if y'all don't want him, the uniform just about fits me.
You have to change him to somebody else.
See, I'm going to change him. You know what I'll do? Take that old cigar out of his mouth, and we'll make him Robert E. Lee.
I've been waiting here, kind of hoping you'd come. Gets mighty lonesome sometimes.
I had to come. We're leaving tomorrow.
Ain't nothing nicer than going up and down the river.
Dr. John's got the appeal lawyer. He's gonna send you the money fast as we take it in.
Sure would like to be in them river towns and see your show.
Oh, it's mighty beautiful.
Fella in here used to work in a tattoo parlor in Perryville. And, well, I kind of been getting some tattooing done myself.
I wished I could see it.
Well, see what it says under the heart?
It's my name.
I've been learning to play the saw, too.
I wish I could hear it.
I only know one tune, and I don't know that very good. Something I gotta tell you, Freaky Bell. You know that girl that waits on table across the street? Well, I waved at her once.
I'll bet she waved at you first. I've gotta go.
Freaky Bell, you ain't never kissed me yet.
Over a little bit. Put her over a little. Get a little more there. Now just hold it steady.
You don't want me to run in that sandbar, do you, Captain John?
Hmm? What is it? Hey, hey, look out here. Say, wait a minute here. Say, you got to make up your mind who you're gonna take orders from, me or you. Now hold her right there now. Right there.
You think I'm learning?
Sure. Say, you're taken to the river just like an old turtle. If you listen to me, and you'll be the best pilot on the whole river. Outside of Duke and me.
I sure would like to get back and see Duke.
You ain't You ain't getting tired of my company already, are you?
Well, you know that ain't so. I ain't never had a home like this. I ain't never known nobody like you. Why, you bought me dresses and pretty things like I ain't never seen before. Sometimes when we're going down the river at night, I get to thinking about Duke and what you've done for him and me. Seems like I can hardly stand it. I feel like the Lord's just shaming me for having hated you so.
Yeah. You have to worry about it. The Lord's a lot broad-minded than you think he is, anyhow. Pull over just a little bit. Look out for this bend now. That's it. Now hold it steady.
Steamboat round the bend!
Hey, that's a river talk. Steamboat round the bend. Steamboat round the bend! Yes, you can. Hey, you know what that is? That's the pride of Paducah. So, Captain Eli. I want to just give that old snapping turtle a toot here to show him my boat can toot louder than him.
Hey, Doc! Don't forget I'm going to own that old mud scow when I win this race.
Yeah, the only time you ever go past me is when you go in the other way.
Say, what are you on that museum? The mummy? And say, you better stay away from Salt Creek. They lynched one of them hoochie-coochie shows there last week.
Yeah, where was you sitting? On the front row?
I sure was. Crapper and crapper.
You know, Captain John, maybe he's right about Salt Creek.
Oh, that old bullfrog don't know what he's talking about. Salt Creek's the last town we're going to show in, then we're going home. See Duke.
Look, say, don't do that.
Ain't nothing will run you on a sandbar quicker than a lot of hugging and kissing.
I didn't mean to.
You didn't mean to? Well, that's a fine thing to say. If you didn't mean to, maybe I better give it back. Too much foolishness going on around here. You run change your clothes right quick now. Put on a fancy dress. Because I'm going to show those folks in Salt Creek some fancy piloting now. Better give them a little toot. Get that information, brother.
Because we're going to chop up your boat, mister.
Yeah, and burn it up, too. We'll give you a turn of travel.
And a bucket of tar for that gal.
Come on, let's pull this fuselage.
I'm telling me gone. Mr. Dog was sitting there standing down there and just looking around. I was so scared and all my life. They got pickaxes and they got it. Professor, I'm telling me gone.
Stand back there.
Hold up your hand.
Look out, Peppy. He's got a gun.
I see him.
I'm gonna shoot.
Hey, wait a minute, boys. Now, don't shoot. Now, just hold that till I tell you. Now, hold them guns right there. Don't shoot. They've got the wrong impression. This ain't no show.
How come she ain't a show? You got a calliope.
Yeah, I know, but this is a museum. This is a museum. It's educational.
How come she's educational?
Well, because Because it is, that's why. Now, hold on. Uncock your gun, boys, because you may let them go off accidentally and shoot them now. Just hold it till I tell you to now. It's educational. Did you ever see a petrified man? Huh? No, you never did. Well, we got one in there, ain't we, honey? Huh? We got one in there, and he's 2,000 years old, too. I tell you, I'm going to let you all come in there and see with your own eyes, and it ain't going to cost you one nickel. And if everything that I've told you about out here ain't in there, just like I told you, then you can come out and you can chop it down if you want to. Now, friends, there ain't nobody that rightfully knows just how old she is. There's people that say a whale grows an inch every 100 years. So, well, you can figure it out for yourself. Now, that's not a fish. This ain't a fish. That's a mammal. It's a mammal, well, I mean, it raises its young just like a cow does. And it breathes just the same as you and I. And when it gets kind of waterlogged, it blows it out through these breathing places right in the top of its head there. I'll show you. He let her breathe a little, will you?
Breathed all over me.
Okay. There you are. Now, is she educational or ain't she?
Yep, sir.
There's a powerful lot of learning in the will. Neighbor, this thing is worth paying for.
Well, I'm glad to hear you say that.
Brick, pass the hat.
Yes, it is.
Here, Rick, if you mind, better get your pappy's hat. Yours leaks. Right over this way, gentlemen. Here's George Washington, the ball of his country. You can't leave without seeing pappy. Now, I told you on the outside that I had George Washington here. Well, I wasn't lying. Yeah. Yeah. Right here.
Friend, that certainly is a fine man. All my life I thought that about him and what he's done for our country here. Will you be here tomorrow?
No, I'm sorry. I won't be here tomorrow.
I sure would like to have my old woman see him, if she can get away from her plowing. She got a picture of him, and ain't more than a week goes by if she don't look at it.
Well, I'm awful sorry, but we got to be in Beaver Slough tomorrow. They're waiting for us there.
Don't suppose you could spare me a piece of his hair, could you now?
Well, no, I don't.
Me and her'd be mighty proud to have a piece of George Washington's hair.
Well, I'm going to give you a little piece here, because I don't want you to have to make your wife quit plowing.
Well, that is.
You be very careful of that. Take good care of that. Right over this way, gentlemen. Right over here. Call your attention to the stage. All right, Petey Bell. All right, Eve. All right, Tony. Gentlemen, General Robert E. Lee. Sheriff. Oh, golly, the way this gal dragged you up that hill, eh? You'd sort of think she wanted to see somebody. Duke?
All fine as a frog here. I never know the man who keeps happy. When you hear him play on that saw, man, he really whips it. And he eats more than a horse.
Hey, you want to feed him good, because ain't nothing too good for Duke, is it, honey, huh?
That's the truth as I see it. Sure hate to see him go and get hung.
What are you talking about? No, what are you joking about a thing like that?
Why, ain't you heard? The coat done turned down his appeal.
Who said so?
Well, sure, Doc, I'm sorry. I thought you knew. I got more orders right here in my pocket. I got a ticket to Baton Rouge tomorrow night.
Duke! Duke!
Fleety Bell.
Duke, it ain't so, is it?
I guess it is.
They can't take you, Duke. They can't.
Oh, don't cry, honey. I guess things just gotta be that way.
I'd just about die if I never was married to you.
Oh, dear, you're such a skinny little thing. You know, my Bonnie Lou got married in this dress. Mm-hmm. I think she was a little stouter than you are, though.
It's awful pretty.
Dear, I wished I had some orange blossoms. Don't seem like no wedding without no orange blossoms. Addie Mae, dear, you run along down and fix the flowers. That's a good girl. Here, you hold these.
Yes, sir, Duke, I'm going to give you a real good one. This makes 13 folks that I was married what are going to get hung. I guess that's a record. Sheriff down at Big Ben, he claimed that he'd done 14, but there was nobody could find where to put down the book. Now, these are I done. Every one of them is wrote right down here in my family Bible where anybody can see them.
Everything's ready, Pop.
That's fine, Adam. You got your flowers all put around? That's good. Doc, got the piano set. Guess we're about ready to go. Now, Adam, can you play the wedding march?
Can't play nothing but listen to the mockingbird.
Well, I reckon that'll have to do as good as anything. We gotta have some music, get the bride in here. We'll run on over to the piano, Dad, here. We'll be ready in just a minute. Ma! Oh, Ma! Not ready?
Yep, we're all waiting.
Well, won't be even a minute now. Now, Pappy, you gotta give her away, because you done it for me when you was in here the last time. Buff, let the boys in. Now, you boys quiet down and get settled now. Don't want to have no disturbance. Gonna start the ceremony in just a minute. Doc? The old jail looks kind of cheerful, don't it? Yeah.
Go ahead, dear, go ahead.
All right, begin, Adam A.
I'm trying
There she comes.
Yeah. Darned old train, it would be on time.
I reckon Duke may be down Baton Rouge before midnight. Hate to do this, Duke, but it's according to the law.
I guess you done all you could, Ruth.
They ain't taking it.
Hey, look out!
No, please!
Oh, Bob, girl, you get away! You get away! They can't get away! No sense in that, honey. I don't want to get you in trouble. Or you either, Uncle John. I don't want to get you no trouble either, Ruth. You've been mighty good to me.
Oh, that's all right, Duke. I ain't holding no grudge.
Well, guess I kind of lost my head, too, and wanted to get seen get away. Don't cry, honey. Ruth ain't gonna hold nothing against you.
You don't reckon we'll be needing these handcuffs, none, Duke, but...
All aboard!
Come on, let's get on.
All aboard!
Don't you worry, honey. You know what we're gonna do, huh? You know, we're gonna get on that boat, and we're gonna go all up and down that river, and we're gonna hunt and hunt till we find the new Moses. We'll find him somewhere.
Hey, brother, you seen anything of the new Moses?
Yes, sir. Up down the swamps baptized about a week ago.
Hello, friend. Hey, have you seen anything of the new Moses?
Brother, he was here 2 weeks ago. And I ain't had a drop since.
Uncle John, come here, look.
What is it, huh? Oh, hey, say, that does look like a baptizing there. That might be him. Pull over there, pull over. Pull right over here.
Hey, brother! Is that the new Moses?
No, brother, but I am the new Elijah.
Wrong prophet.
The folks out there, but they don't look like they've seen anybody.
Hey, brother! You seen anything of the new Moses?
Brother, I ain't even seen the old Moses!
Great thing.
Well, your joke's old enough. You ought to have seen the old Moses. Looks like we missed him everywhere we're gone, Fleety Bell.
Duke ain't got much time left, Uncle John.
I know that. I've been racking my brain every night and day since the thing happened. I don't know. I just wouldn't want to go on living if they hang that boy.
I ain't going to neither. But they ain't gonna hang Duke. I'm not saying we're gonna save him, but they ain't gonna hang him.
I don't know. Nobody but the Lord knows about that.
Ain't got but 2 days left.
Yeah, see, wait, I got enough. Take the wheel and hold. You know, let me think a minute. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going right and see the governor.
Could you?
Yes, I'm good. What they say, he ain't forgot us old soldiers. You know, I remember him at Shiloh. He was certainly dealing them Yankees a powerful lot of misery there then. You know, I'm just going to go see him and tell him that we can't find the new Moses and this is not Duke's fault. Come on, let's put her around here now. We'll turn right around and get into... take her straight into Baton Rouge.
Oh, what's the idea of his coming up here now? Don't he know we got a race on?
that? What's he doing? Waving us in there?
Go back, will you? Go back, I say! I'm gonna have a race!
Hey! What's the idea of waving us in there? We're going on up the river!
The river's been cleared for the race, Doc! Nobody can get through until they get away! Get that floating henhouse out of the way, will you?
Henhouse? What's he doing, calling this thing a henhouse? What are you talking about?
Why don't you do as I tell you? Come back!
What do you mean, a henhouse calling this?
Oh, henhouse can't understand English! I said go back and I meant go back, not upriver!
Now, you captains ain't gonna start until the cannons go off. Then you can do what you please. Now, the first boat that reaches Baton Rouge wins the race as well as the prize from the governor's own hand.
Hey, Clay, hey, what's the idea of flagging me in here?
Sorry, Doc, but you know the rules of the race.
I'm not in the race. I don't care nothing about the race. I'm trying to get to Baton Rouge.
Oh, no, you ain't either. I know you'd try to back out of that race. Scared you'll lose that old chicken coop.
Chicken coop nothing. Say, do you still want to bet the pride of Paducah against the Clam O'Queen?
As I recall, that was the terms of the bet, unless you were crawfishing. Winner takes both boats.
Yeah. Is that so? Well, I'll tell you, I'll just take you up on that. I'll bet you my boat against yours. Whole hog or none with me. I'll go in the race. Of course, it'll slow me up going down to Baton Rouge, but I'll go in. What time do we start?
Well, old man Sergeant Benson shoots off that cannon in about 5 minutes.
Now, wait a minute. Now, give me time to load on some firewood, will you? I'm putting you out.
Same old Pokey Hunters, always full alibis. You couldn't win if you put wings on. She starts when the gun goes off. Now, that's the rule. You fellas better hurry and get on your boats.
I don't want to start off by running over them floating waxworks.
Get ready, Cap. Cannon's about to go boom. Get ready, below.
Hey, come on here, Friedel. You're standing around.
Are we really going in the race?
No, we're going in the race. We've got to get out on the river anyhow.
Running in front of the line.
Hey, Doc. Better hug close to shore. No telling when that old honey wagon's going to sink.
Ah, you shut up, y'all.
Push up.
Hey, Eve, stand by now. Pull ahead of steam on all the time.
Come on, honey. Come on, Jimmy, you better let me here now. Well, it's gonna take a good man here. I want to get a flying start on him now. That's the boat we've got to beat. Is this Pride of Paducah?
Hey, Uncle Jeff, wrap your spring line.
now, if we can just hold him.
Yeah, but the Cherokee's catching up with us, Uncle John.
Yeah, yeah. Holler down to Eve. Holler down to Eve there and tell him to pull the wood to her.
Eve, what steam you can!
I'm just wondering, Mink, where we're going to put that prize when we win it tomorrow. Down in the clerk's office?
In the potter's house, I should say.
Well, maybe that would be best.
Over there and get right in behind Captain, in his backwash, right in there.
Uh-huh.
Because if he can, the Lord has given me an idea.
Get sound asleep. Take us your cigar in my mouth, will you? Word up, 3-4 steamboats that way.
Morning, mate.
Morning, Captain.
Morning, Captain Eli. Have a good night.
Holin' jumping catfish. Fletch! Fletch, get an axe! Get an axe and chop that old scow loose! Doc, you connive an old scoundrel! It ain't fair! It ain't fair!
I'm just as sore about it as you are, Captain Eli, when I found out we'd been pushing you all night.
Ah, son. I wouldn't keep watching that scaffold if I were you.
I ain't seen it, Reverend. I was watching up the river. I sure thought Uncle John and Flea Bell would be here today.
Well, maybe they'll be able to get here yet. I'll stay here with you.
How much time I got?
Oh, a couple of hours. Let me read to you a little.
Please.
The fire's dying out, Doc. The boiler's getting cold. She ain't got another lick in her. We're sure lick now.
Oh, you got to keep the fires going.
Ain't got nothing else to burn.
Well, burn that museum.
Huh? Right. Moses! Doc says burn up the museum!
Let me put an idea.
Oh,
Mr.
George, why don't you... I wonder how come...
Seem fair. Here they're gonna hang Duke and Wynn spitting distance of Baton Rouge.
Well, nothing can save us now but the power of prayer. Hey, what are you drinking there?
Medicine.
Brother Eve, you've been deceiving me. That's Stephen Rump.
Hey, that's Pocahontas. It's never failed us yet. Say, we got 10 gallons here.
Ten. We got 100.
And burn it up. Down with demon rum! Down with the demon rum! Down with it! Down with the demon rum! Here we are, here to the pirates! Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
I'm...
Look down upon this thy son.
Excuse me, Reverend. Say, Duke, is there any last request you'd like to make?
I sure would like to see the finish of that race.
Well, I ain't got no objection to that. But Rufe here told me that you...
Now, that's all right, Warden. Anything the Duke wants to do suits me. It's all right.
Well, I'd like to see the finish of that race myself. So if it's all right with you, we let her go just as soon as the Pride of Paducah comes around the bend.
Thank you, sir.
It won't be long.
There she comes!
Well, all right, son, let's go.
Wait a minute! That ain't the Pride of Paducah! It's a Clamor Queen!
Strength. Grant him courage.
Oh, wait! Wait! Wait!